what they did to us was, well, the term for this in the FBI is COINTELPRO, counterintelligence program. And what that means, this is a program that was started by J. Edgar Hoover back in the bad old days, and now in the bad new days, they still do it. And COINTELPRO, that J. Edgar Hoover described, it's a way of they targeting domestic radical groups that they think are a threat to the U.S. government. So I guess that's quite a compliment to us. And I guess we're a threat to Charles Hurwitz, and he's more powerful than the government, so maybe it all adds up. But anyway, what J. Edgar Hoover described COINTELPRO as a program, these are his words, to expose, misdirect, isolate, and neutralize political groups that he didn't like. And that's really what's been done to Earth First. And the methods that they used in COINTELPRO include disinformation, fake documents, infiltration, agent provocateurs, fomenting infighting within a group, getting the group to do things so that they will be discredited, and also framing and assassinating leaders. And the most famous victims of COINTELPRO, well, you probably all know that Martin Luther King was spied on in his motel room. And that, you know, of course, in the Black Panthers, there were many Panthers killed, 32 in all. Fred Hampton was a famous victim of COINTELPRO. He was murdered in his bed. Geronimo Pratt is one that's still in jail now, 26 years later, something like that, really a very long time. And he, in fact, was framed by the very same guy, Richard Held, the same guy that was in charge of our case at the FBI was in charge of Geronimo's case down in Los Angeles. And what they did, and of course Leonard Peltier is another very well-known victim of COINTELPRO. And what they did in these cases, I actually brought you some examples to show you. They did the exact kind of thing that I'm talking about. In the Black Panthers, they didn't just frame Geronimo. Before they framed him and put him in jail, they fomented infighting within the leadership so that people in the Black Panthers thought that Geronimo was an FBI agent. So that when he was then framed, the other Panthers wouldn't testify in his behalf. And one of the ways that they fomented this infighting is that they had these like nasty cartoons. Now, the FBI doesn't make up the divisions in your group. They take real divisions and they kind of fan the flames of them. So there was another group, a Black nationalist group, as opposed to a Black revolutionary group, which was the Panthers was, and the other group was called United Slaves, or US, U.S. And the leader of the United Slaves was named Karenga. So what they did is they had these cartoons, and these cartoons were sent from one faction to the other and back and forth, cartoons, death threats, and insulting letters, and each faction thinking that the cartoons and letters were from the other faction, and they were all from the FBI until everybody, well, actually, there were actually two Panthers killed in the fighting that resulted from this, which they considered a great success. So eventually, COINTELPRO was exposed, and it was exposed not because of anything the U.S. government did, but because in 1971, some people, we know not who, broke into the FBI office in Media, Pennsylvania, and liberated the files. And and back then, they used to be very open. They called it COINTELPRO. They said, we have an order to neutralize Huey Newton. They even had an order to neutralize Tom Hayden. And hey, didn't they do it? So they got these files, about 10,000 pages of them, and they went through them and they exposed this just really horrible program. And it took them 4 years to get a congressional hearing, but they eventually got a congressional hearing in the Senate before Senator Church. It was called the Church Committee, and this was in 1975. And at that time, they ruled, the U.S. Senate Committee ruled that COINTELPRO was illegal, that it violated basic constitutional rights of U.S. citizens. And as a result of this, you may have heard of the Attorney General guidelines. This is what's kind of being undermined by the counterterrorism bill. So they passed these things called the Attorney General guidelines, and they set rules for the FBI and what they could and couldn't do. And what they said they couldn't do is they cannot spy on people, they cannot harass people, they can't engage with people because of political activities. That's what they're banned from doing. They're only allowed to investigate crime. They're not allowed to investigate radical political groups or any political groups. And they are allowed to investigate a group if the group is a terrorist group. And yet what we've found in our case is that, you know how with the forestry rules, they have all these forestry rules, you know, so that we have the strongest rules in the United States and all that stuff, but they do this little dance around the rules and they still cut down every tree in the forest. Well, the FBI does the exact same thing with the Attorney General guidelines, okay? They do this little dance around them, but they still manage to do whatever they feel like. like. And what we found out in the bombing case and in 1990, what we've been learning ever since, is that really what they've been doing to Earth First is exactly the kind of COINTELPRO that they did to the Panthers, that they did to AIM, not quite on the same scale. They haven't killed 32 of us. But nonetheless, the same methodologies that they used against the Panthers and AIM and all of those other groups are the same methodologies that they've used to try to isolate and neutralize and misdirect Earth First.